Today, the White House again instructing former West Wing aides to give Democrats nothing, at least about their time working in the White House. Hope Hicks, the former communications director, and Annie Donaldson, the former chief of staff to White House counsel Don McGahn, faced morning subpoena deadlines to turn over documents connected to their time working for the administration. Both were witnesses in the special counsel investigation, and both key players in the special counsel laid out potential examples of obstructing justice by the president. We should note Hope Hicks has agreed to turn over some documents to the House Judiciary Committee relating to her time on the Trump campaign, not in the Trump White House. Let's get straight to Mano Raju on Capitol Hill. Mano, the White House again saying no.
Indeed, they are rejecting these demands, but specifically about the time that Hope Hicks, the former White House communications director, as well as Annie Donaldson, who is the chief of staff for Don McGahn, who was, of course, then the White House counsel, their time in the White House. And, of course, that's central to what the Democrats want to investigate in the House Judiciary Committee, looking into potential obstruction of justice to examine those 10 episodes laid out by the Mueller report as part of the president's apparent efforts to undermine that investigation. The White House is saying those records will not be turned over. In the letter that we just reviewed from the White House counsel, Pat Cipollone, he says that those are confidential communications that Congress is not entitled to. He proposes instead to discuss a middle ground between the House Democrats and the House and the Department of Justice to see if they can find any sort of deal. But I can tell you, John, that a number of Democrats that I have spoken with are just not satisfied with this request so far, or this offer to work with them. One Democratic member, Jamie Raskin, just said moments ago that this is essentially going to add more weight to the calls to do more, potentially even open up an impeachment inquiry. That's something, of course, the House Speaker so far is resisting, as well as the House Judiciary Chairman, Jerry Nadler, who is not going that far. Now, one thing that Nadler did note was the fact that Hope Hicks has agreed to turn over campaign-related documents to the committee, not her time at the White House, but campaign-related documents. That is not going to satisfy Democrats here. So the next step could be more members, former officials, being held in contempt. John.
Mano Raju, live from the Hill. Appreciate the update. Let's bring it in the room. And just for a little context, Hope Hicks was close to the president during the campaign, probably nobody closer to him on a day-to-day basis around him all the time. But the reason Congress wants is she was on Air Force One, for example, when they were drafting the statement about the Trump Tower meeting with Donald Jr. that was not accurate, to be kind. I could do more. And many other issues there. Annie Donaldson, Don McGahn says he got the phone call from the president. Get Rosenstein to fire Mueller. So these are two key witnesses. The White House answer is no, no, no.
What the White House is doing is really trying to just test Democratic leadership. How long can Nancy Pelosi hold off her members as the requests get closer to the president, closer to the people around him, and the answer continues to be no? You know, can Pelosi, can she say to her members, you know, that she is doing everything she can, right, if she doesn't go down the road of opening impeachment hearings? Hope Hicks clearly is trying to show some level of cooperation, some good faith effort here. But to your point, what they want to know about is what happened when she was in the White House. What happened in the campaign is somewhat irrelevant to what Democrats are after. And that's what makes her willingness to go along with this White House position, I think, so frustrating and troublesome for a lot of Democrats.
And to your point about testing the leadership, Nancy Pelosi's own members are testing her, too. Before Robert Mueller spoke last week, 35 Democrats had called for an impeachment inquiry. After he spoke, the number jumped to 38. The president spoke the next day, the number jumped to 43. Mm-hmm. As of today, 57 members of the House Democratic Caucus say we should at least open an impeachment inquiry. Now, again, there's more than 200 of them, so we're getting in the range of about 25% now. But the number keeps growing. Pelosi's job managing the flock gets more difficult.
Right, and I think Julie's correct that every time we see another episode of these, you know, they ask for something and they're told no, that is going to continue to grow. I think what Nancy Pelosi and her team are trying to do is to sort of find ways of letting the steam out of the kettle a little bit, and that I think part of that will happen when they actually vote to hold. That's why they're going to have votes to hold Don McGahn and others in contempt. We may see them go down that road with these additional figures here, Hope Hicks and Annie Donaldson, but clearly they are going to come to a point where there is not going to be a whole lot of ability for them to get at crucial information that they would need to flesh out what is in the Mueller report and what they do know about obstruction. And the question is, you know, when is that? And then how many more Democrats have signed on to this effort at that point?
And to that point, if you want to question Nancy Pelosi's hold, especially on the leadership, this is her number three, James Clyburn, on TV with Jake Tapper on Sunday. Seems pretty clear.
But it sounds like you think that the president will be impeached or at least proceedings will begin in the House at some point, but just not right now.
Yes, exactly what I feel. I think we've already begun it.
That was Sunday. The day after Sunday is Monday. Here's Congressman Clyburn to Politico. I'm probably farther away from impeachment than anybody in our caucus. We will not get out in front of our committees. We'll see what the committees come up with. I've said that forever.
You must have gotten a phone call.
and to the point, 25% of the Democratic caucus is still just 25%. Right. That's really not a breaking point, I think, for the leadership, who really does not want to have this fight right now.
Right. The speaker's position in a leadership meeting and a members meeting the other day was she still thinks this is a bad idea. And for now, she's holding firm. We shall see. It's-